Thank you. Thanks. I was told I was doing Carpool Karaoke, so this is a bit of a letdown and a lot of pressure. So, I'm bad in bed. I think we should get that out of the way. I mean that in every way. I'm bad at sleeping. I am the little spoon in my relationship. I am a male little spoon. There's not a lot of us. We're not out there winning wars, but we exist. I don't like being the big spoon. It makes my belly hot. I'm not gonna do it anymore. I'm a feminist. I think a woman can do anything a man can do, and that includes holding me in the fetal position until I fall asleep. This isn't the 1950s. Get out of that kitchen, put your apron down, and come in here and press your boobies against my back. I don't know what you're gonna do with your other arm. You wanted equal rights, figure it out. You're not jamming it under my neck, I promise you that. I have a $120 pillow that remembers how I sleep. I'm not letting you shove skin and elbow under there. I'm also a father, I am a dad, I have a 3.5-year-old daughter that I love more than anything in the entire world, and that includes my 10-month-old daughter. Not a fan. I've heard my whole life that you love your children equally and you can't have a favorite, and yet the first time I held her, I thought, nope. I've been lied to. Bring back that old baby. We brought our new baby home from the hospital, as you do, and we sat her on the floor, which is the thing that happens. My old daughter comes up and she goes, Daddy, when she wakes up, can I teach her something? Well, that's the sweetest thing I've ever heard, favorite baby. Of course you can teach her something. It's one less thing I'll have to do with her. And then she woke up and my daughter goes, I want her to stop breathing. Well, this took a hard left. She said, I want her to stop breathing. And then she just covered the baby's mouth and nose with her hand. And that's how you make people stop breathing. And I didn't come here to brag about my kids, but it's very advanced for a 3-year-old. I can't afford them. I cannot afford these kids. And I mean my kids, specifically. I could afford 2 kids. I can't afford mine. I got expensive broads running around my house. My 3-year-old orders off the adult menu everywhere we go like she's a Kardashian or something. We were out to dinner one night, and she goes, Daddy, can I have salmon? I didn't have salmon until I was 29 years old. You can have the fingers of a chicken. Or the tender part of a chicken. Hot part of a dog. You see where this is going. We're done having kids, which means I don't have to go into delivery rooms anymore. Hopefully, right? I think it's stupid to bring a dad into a delivery room. Doesn't help. It's worthless. No dad has ever helped. No one knows one story of a dad helping. The doctor bursts through the doors, pulls down his mask. We were in some real trouble back there. Luckily, that man was roaming around in everyone's way. Pointing to things, saying, what's this do? And where can I plug in my phone? He's the real hero. They make you dress like a doctor. I didn't know that. You have to put on doctor scrubs. Not dad scrubs. Doctor scrubs. You roam the halls of a hospital dressed like a doctor. People coming up to me. Are you a doctor? No, I just banged that gal on the table a while back. And they let me dress up like this. The only reason they want the dad in the room is so you can take a picture of the baby way before it's time to take a picture of a baby. This doctor pulls it out. And, Daddy, take the picture. No, oh, I don't want it and you can't make me. She's purple and dripping and still hooked up. Can you unplug her first? Who am I going to show this picture to? You want to see the scariest thing you've ever seen in your whole life? Ah! All right, that's it for me, guys. Thank you very much.